Hey there, we're now going to go over the creation of a ribbon emitter. Now, a ribbon is going to create a ribbon of particles, hence the name, from another emitter in the same particle system. So to do this, let's go into our My Particle folder we've been working on so far. Let's do as we've been doing. We'll create a new folder, which we will call ribbon. We'll jump inside and we'll start. We could start off with a new material. That would be completely reasonable. However, this is going to take a material that is essentially the same as the one we made for the beam emitter. So I'm going to jump into that folder real quick, and let's make a copy of that, which I'll just call, actually we'll drag it into the folder, we'll copy it, jump into that folder, and let's rename this. We'll call it mat underscore ribbon. We could just reuse it straight up. I'm just doing this for overall cleanliness and so that I can open it up. And if you didn't follow that last video, you could probably just pause the video right here, and you have all the information you need to recreate this material yourself. So that was enough time for you to have paused and to have done that. So we'll close that, and now we're ready to create the particle system itself. So we'll call this P underscore ribbon. And we'll open it up. Okay, now this is gonna be a two-parter. Actually, to be fair, let's put Cascade away for just a minute. We'll get back to that. We don't really need to make another material for that, but I'm also gonna go over to our original sprite material, which we called Matte Sparks. I'm gonna copy that in here as well. And if you need to see that material, it's even simpler. It's just a radial gradient exponential that is multiplied by a particle color. So we take the color, multiply that to drive emissive. We take the alpha and drive that to drive opacity. So again, that should be enough for you to recreate that with the help of your pause button. So now that we have that, let's rename it. And we will call this mat underscore ribbon source. And you'll see why here in just a moment. Now let's go into Cascade. And that makes me much happier. Okay, so let's get our material applied. Some folks like to do the behavior first, not worry about the material. I like having some sort of a material ready to go, but that's just a workflow thing, so it's entirely your world. Let's take initial size, let's pull that down. Let's do something like, let's do fives all down the board. I've had folks ask me before, is there any sort of performance gain in using like a constant with a single value as opposed to using min-max of the same value? If there is one, it should be completely imperceptible. So it really shouldn't matter whatsoever. Or it does not matter. Let's just go ahead and say that. So feel free to just set min and max to the same thing if you don't want to change out for a constant. Okay, in initial velocity, let's kick these out in a kind of a wider dispersal pattern. So let's do 30 by 30 and negative 30 by negative 30. So they're flying out in all directions. Let's go ahead and pick the upward velocity up a little bit. So 200 by 100. And then let's add some acceleration to pull it back down to the ground. So let's, not drag. I didn't really want drag. We want constant acceleration. And we will set that to a Z value of negative 500 or so. Okay, so those are... Oh, they're doing their thing, aren't they? But I feel like that could be a little slower. So 200, and then I'm gonna pull down my initial velocity. Let's go back to 100 by 50. Okay, well, it's a start. What happens if I do 50 by 50 or 50 by 30? That's a little slower. And then we'll pull this up to 500. Just not quite what I want, is it? Oh, I want negative 500. That's silly of me. Negative, so I'm trying to pull down, remember? So negative 10, that's starting to pull down. Particle systems are a lot of this, right? So it's just a lot of kind of tweak and trial and error. That's starting to get a little bit better. Now let's just kick the lifetime up. Let these live for about 5 seconds apiece. Awesome, that's kind of what I want. I want them to puff up into the air and then fall back down. Let's see, the only other things that I want to do at this point, we don't need quite so many. Let's do maybe a fourth of that. That should be fine. Okay, so now we've got some color over life. I don't really want that. We could just do initial color for this, just to keep things simple. So let's swap out to color, do initial color, and we'll set that to, I don't know, let's do something red. So we'll do 20 by 5 by 1. That's kind of orangish. That's mostly red. So we'll do that. Let's take the required module. We'll set screen alignment to PSA velocity. We will add a size by speed. And we'll set the scale of this to 4 in Y. So there we go. So now they're starting to kind of stretch out. Looks like flaming hot pieces of rice, which is kind of funny. Okay, so now we are ready to add our ribbon emitter. So let's go ahead and create our very first emitter totally from scratch. We'll just right click, create a new particle sprite emitter. We will immediately right click and set a type data of ribbon. And suddenly everything seems to disappear, which is no good for us. So there it is. So it took a second to calculate, and that's not what we want at all. The key to a ribbon is a couple of things. First off, take your spawn and set the spawn rate to 0. So you're not really spawning anything. Replace that, go under spawn, and you're going to add spawn per unit. And we're going to set the spawn per unit rate to 1. And that's almost going to get us there. The last thing we need to add is a trail source. Then in that module, in trail source, we're going to set the source method to particle. So these are going to be emitted from a particle. And we're going to take the source name. And we need to name this emitter. Currently, it's named particle emitter. And naming your emitters is actually a lot more important than I've let on. So let's show how to do that. We'll go to emitter and choose rename emitter. And we'll call this ribbon source. And over here in our source module, we'll just set the source name to, you guessed it, ribbon source. All right, so that's getting us somewhere near where we want to be, but it's not quite perfect just yet. First off, the required module, we could use our real material, and that would probably be a lot better. So let's take matte ribbon, we'll drag that in like so. Also, under ribbon data, we have max sheets per trail, we have max trail count. Let's set that to something like 50, so we can have up to 50 trails at a given moment. And those are starting to look pretty good, but still kind of terrible. Let's take initial size and pull that way down. In fact, we're going to set that to a constant, and that'll be something like 2 by 2. And that's starting to kind of happen. We also need to get rid of the initial velocity. I mean, that's cool for kind of simulating some smoke. As a matter of fact, just kind of as a really random case of curiosity and nothing else, if I take, let's see, sheets per trail, and we kick that up to like 10, I mean, that's starting to look a little bit like smoke. So you could probably simulate smoke that way, but I don't really want to do that. So to fix that, we just take our initial velocity and make it go away. So now we really are just leaving trails behind, as you can see. We need to take a lifetime and kick it up though. So let's do a lifetime of about 3 seconds. And now we see we're leaving those nice trails behind. We can take the color over life and remove that. We'll replace it with a standard initial color. And we'll make this something really, really intensely blue. So let's do a Z of 20, or a blue of 20, and then like three for green. So now we're getting sort of these nice neonish streaks. I guess the only thing we could do to make things look a little bit better is we could do a, let's add a color over life back in. And let's see, we don't necessarily need the initial, the actual color to change over life. So if we take that, all right, we're gonna remove our initial color, I changed my mind, because I want these to fade out, and that's my real problem. So let's take color over life. I'm just gonna take the actual color part of it, and we'll change that to a constant value right inside of here. And that, again, can just be some intense blue, so it'll be 20. For blue, and I think I did like 5 for green just to give it a little bit of a cyanish kind of color. Then for alpha over life, we will create a curve. So we already have a curve that goes down from 1, so in value of 0, so at birth it has a value of 1. And then at death, which is an in value of 1, it has an out value of 0, which is faded out. We're going to pull that back to about 0.7. So that means these are going to be faded out much sooner. And that helps get rid of the jaggy popping at the end of the trail by just a little bit. So let's maybe pull it down to like 0.4. So we'll fade them out really early. And that just kind of helps, right? So you don't see quite as much of that popping at the end. So now if you take that and use that, just kick up the lifetime, you could, because the lifetime can be really high now. Because if we take a look at the ribbon data, dead trails on deactivate and dead trails on source loss. So if they lose their source particles, then they go bye-bye. So you can use this, you know, the lifetime. I'm actually going to set it back down. Let's use like 4x4. So there we go. And let's bring this into the level now. So P ribbon. There we go. And hit G. So yeah, we've got some particles that are leaving little ribbons behind. So that is a really simple look at creating ribbons. Again, it's just a way to create sort of a ribbon-like effect based off of another particle system. That's going to wrap things up for this video. Thank you so much for watching.